Hi, this is Venkat. Today I am going to explain Informatica interview questions. So I am planning a total 20 series of videos. So today I am going to explain very basic interview questions. I am going to explain in each video around 10 questions. So in order to get easily the latest updates, just subscribe to the channel so you don't miss any new videos. So I'm going to talk on the questions. First one, what are different client tools available in Power Center? We all know Power Center Designer, Power Center Workflow Manager, Power Center Workflow Monitor, and Power Center Repository Manager. What is the use of Power Center Designer? The Power Center Designer tool is used to create or import sources, targets, to create reusable transformations, to create maplets and mappings. What is the use of Power Center Workflow Manager? In Workflow Manager, we are going to create sessions, different types of tasks, worklets, workflows, etc. What is the use of Power Center Workflow Monitor? Using Power Center Workflow Monitor, we are going to view the statuses of workflows, sessions, any other tasks. What is the use of Power Center Repository Manager? The Power Center Repository Manager is used by Informatica admin as well as Informatica developers also in real time. So as a developer, you are going to export, import XMLs from one environment to another environment. As a administrator, you can create folders, you can give permissions, and you can create groups, different things as a admin you can do using Power Center Repository Manager. Next one, how many ways you can create a source definition? So this is a developer thing. So there are two ways to create a source definition. For example, I want to create a Oracle source. One option is sources import from database and connect. Now you can say employee. Click on OK. Already exist, replace. You can see here. This is one way you can import, or another way is you can create also. Sources, create. So here select whatever you want to work. So here employee. In this case, you need to add manually columns. Employee number, employee name, so data types it will show here. Whatever the data types you want, you can do. These are Oracle data types only. So in these two ways you can create a source definition. If you want to define a key also, you can define primary key, apply. Now you can see key symbol. So these are the two ways you can create a source definition. Next, how to compare two source definitions? So when you are working in a team in real time, sometimes your project code exists in one project folder and your individual code as a developer exists in another folder. In order to move the code from your individual folder to project folder, sometimes you have to compare instead of replacing it. How can you compare? So suppose I have here two folders. I want to compare STU1 and STU2. First open two folders. Now go to sources, compare. So here I'm going to browse. In STU folder I want to compare employee, and here source2 I'm going to select employee here. So not only between two folders, you can compare from one repository to another repository as well. Same. Click on compare. See here a red line. Sorry, red mark. Here it shows the difference. This is STU, this is STU1. And go to table. See, owner name is source 30. Here owner name is source 111. Go to columns. You see here flags, extra column is city here. There is no city column here. In the ename, you can see what is the difference also. It is showing in red color 20. Here the length is 10. That is the difference. So in this way, you can compare source definitions between folders or between repositories. Next one, how to view source data in source analyzer. So here, select your source, right click. You can use preview data option. Enter the owner name and password. Source. See, you can view the data. Instead of going to table, you can view the data in the Informatica source analyzer itself. So by default, it will show 100 rows. If you want to see more rows, you can change the number here. So suppose how to export only source structure. So what you need to do, select your source, right click. Here you have option export objects. So select desktop, it will be exported as an XML. And next one, how to check same source using what are all the mappings. This is very important in real time. Suppose I want to know, if I change my source, what are all the mappings going to impact? In interviews also sometimes this is a major question, several people ask. So suppose if you want to replace the source, what will be the impact? How do you check what are all the mappings going to impact in your project? So what you need to do is, so first select your source. Example, I want to see here STU1. So here I am selecting employee. So here select this, right click, there is option dependencies. Unselect all, select only mappings. Click on, see, it shows the window. So these are all the mappings impacted. That means in all these mappings the same source is used. So in this way you can do the analysis. So going forward in a coming series of release videos, I am going to enter into depth questions, whatever they will ask in interviews. So in order to get all video series is automatically, just subscribe to the channel. Thank you.